mess yourself up. Oh, sorry.
Welcome back. Kim Crowe-Shaner's here, and we're talking about a volunteer fair.
That is right.
Volunteer fair.
It's our fifth annual volunteer fair in partnership with the Chamber of Commerce in Mountain Home.
Okay.
So the big news is it's not just volunteers in the library. You do volunteers for all kinds of organizations.
Right.
Okay, good.
This is an open house where we just invite organizations in the community who rely upon volunteers to do the good work that they do to come to the library, and we have a little booth space for them. And then we ask folks in the community who are thinking about volunteering, and this being January, we all have our New Year's resolutions. Mm-hmm. A lot of folks say, well, I'm going to give back this year and do some volunteer work, but you might not be certain about where you'd like to volunteer, where your skills could best be utilized. You can come to the volunteer fair. It's an open house format. Just kind of wander around and visit with the different organizations and find out where you fit in and where you can help.
Now, what are some of the organizations that are going to be there?
We've got about 30 currently registered at the time of this recording, and I imagine we'll have a few more. They're in the healthcare industry. They're animal shelters, there's educational charities, so there's just a whole lot of different organizations that need help. It's too long to list. Literacy Council is one of them that always come. At the library, we rely very heavily on volunteers at the library, so we will have a booth ourselves and be hopefully recruiting a few volunteers.
Some of the people
in
the hospital, like hospice and some of the organizations in the hospital, do they come over too?
Yes, yes. Any nonprofit organization you can find at the event.
Well, this being the fifth year, you would think that there wouldn't be any volunteers. All the organizations would be full, but is that not the case? Right?
It's not the case. We have several hundred people come every year, and either there's new folks that have moved to the area, or people just deciding that that's what they want to do, that they would like to give a little bit of their time, you know, to help out other people.
And do you have volunteers that, and I'm sure this happens, they do one thing for a while, and they say, I don't want to change and look at some other possibilities.
Sure. Yeah. Sure. Stir it up a little bit. Change it up a little bit. If you've been volunteering somewhere for a while and you feel like you could give somewhere else, then I invite you to come to the volunteer fair and check it out.
Well, no place ever says, oh, we have plenty of volunteers. We don't. Now, everyone's always looking for help. And people can do office work. Mm-hmm. They can do, drive some of the Meals on Wheels, organizations like that. So, will you have like something that a person fills out? These are the skills I have. I'm retired, whatever. Or these are some of the things I've volunteered in the past. Or do you just wander around?
You just kind of walk around in a real casual, low pressure kind of a situation, and then visit with the different organizations that you think you might be interested in, and they can kind of let you know where their needs are. I know you mentioned different ways that you can help, like if you have if you're limited physically, like you can't stand for very long or whatever, you know, there's a lot of places that have, like you said, maybe office work where you can sit and be still. We have different jobs at the library, for instance, where you might have to move around a lot, shelving books or whatever, but then we may have other things that you could do where you wouldn't have to do that. So and a lot of the organizations are like that. They're looking for anyone that has some time. And
now, when is this?
It's Saturday, January 22nd, and it's from 10 to 2 at the Donald W. Reynolds Library.
But it's drop-in. It's open from 10 to 2. People just
come in whenever you can make it and stay as long as you would like.
Okay. Now, being at the library, does library personnel have first pick over the volunteers?
No.
There you go. We get this one.
We capture them as they first
walk
in.
You grab before they go. Yeah.
No. You just come in, wander around, visit with whomever you would like. Mm-hmm. And a lot of folks will, you know, if you think you're interested, they'll take your name and number and maybe follow up with you if you want them to or not. It's just very, very, like I said, low pressure, just kind of, you know, to get educated on what's out in the community and who needs volunteers.
Well, there are lots of people who move and they want to help, but they don't know yet.
Yeah, you're new to the community. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Or if you've, which is, I can't imagine people doing this, but if you suddenly found yourself with an extra hour a week with nothing to do, all of a sudden,
sure,
you know.
New retirees, things like that. There are people who've cut back, or the kids have left home, and you have a little bit of extra time.
And you want to get out of the house.
Now, this was started by the library, is that right? Or
We dreamt it up, actually, 5 years ago as part of a teen program that we started. They were doing community service work, and our Teen Library Council dreamt this up. They had a lot of things to choose from. They picked that project, and it was such a huge hit the first year that we've brought it back every year, and it's grown, so it's not just a teen project anymore. Although the teens are, the Teen Library Council is sponsoring a bake sale during So if you don't want to volunteer but you just want to eat, you can
bring your extra change, or if you're one of the few people in Baxter County haven't toured the library yet, come out and tour. That'd be a great time to come out and take a look at the new library too.
Definitely. It's amazing that I'll find a few people that have still not come over there. I can't imagine, because curiosity would have got to me before now, but there are a few folks that haven't made it out, so it would be good to come and see the library. Definitely.
Just January?
January 22nd from 10 a.m.
Saturday
to 2 p.m. That's a Saturday at the Donald W. Reynolds Library.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Thanks
get
for
involved.
Coming by.
Thank you for
involved.
Having me on.
Now, do you volunteer at all?
I actually don't right
too
now.
Busy.
She's paid to work there. Okay.
I kind of started out at the library, though, as a volunteer years ago.
A lot of people do that.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
That's how they work into certain. They do a little bit of volunteering, and then someone says, man, you're doing such a great job. Would you be interested in a full-time position? Yeah.
That might be a way for people to gravitate into a certain position.
That happens, I think, more than we realize.
If you're a young person looking to build a resume.
Oh, I can't say enough about a young person coming and volunteering. And we have a lot of teenagers that volunteer at the library.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's a great way to build a resume.
I agree.
Again, that's January 22nd.
Second
Saturday from
10
to 2. Come out to the library and enjoy.
Thank you.
And volunteer. Thanks,
yes.
Kim. Thanks for being here. Up next, we have
the Twirling Fun Timer Square Dance Group, Craig Grothaus and Jerry Hill. Grothaus or Grothaus? I was close. He'll tell me. It's the Twirling Fun Timer Square Dance Group. So that's cool. Okay. I mean, maybe they're giving lessons or something.
They might.
I don't know.
We'll find out all about that in just a couple of minutes. Thank you. We'll be right back. Thanks, Kim.